Richard Dawkins is in Australia right now, and he debated the Catholic Archbishop today on Australian television, and it was a total massacre. It was just ridiculous. George Pell, who is the Catholic Archbishop of Australia, he had nothing to say. It was quite embarrassing. He made numerous very, very fundamental errors in the things he was talking about when he was talking about science. And the rest of it really was, like, rambling. It was almost incoherent. And I kind of felt bad for him. And Dawkins has had much better debates, just because his opponent was much more interesting and quick-witted than Pell in other places. But as with all of these debates, and that's why I don't really watch them anymore much, I watch this one because it's in Australia and it was George Pell, our Archbishop, who I have a bit of a personal kind of animosity towards. Sad to say, I shouldn't, but he's very frustrating on many issues. He's even a climate change skeptic. But you know, when I watch these debates, the same thing came to my mind that usually does. It says same old thing. Like, they took some audience or questions from home as well, and there was that same old question about the universe from nothing and all of that stuff, and it's so stale, and it's so boring at this stage. And it was just so easy to anticipate all of the basic stuff that any such basic debate goes through. And what it made me think about is just my own journey towards atheism, having been I was born Catholic, but I grew up deist, I guess nominally Christian, nominally Catholic, but just believing in God. For a long time, I wanted to believe in a God. And I guess, you know, I wanted to believe in all those other good things, afterlife and so on and so on. And religion has actually helped me in my life. And that's why I guess I have sympathy for religion and the religious. Because I have to say, while I was growing up, being a somewhat, I guess, emotional kid or whatever you want to call it, it gave me great comfort. Now, I don't believe that that makes it any more true, and that is not something that ever gave it more of a feeling of truth to me when I look back at it, but it was something that did help me. You know, it helped me go to sleep when I was up being anxious and worrying in my teenage years. It helped me relax in situations where I was very uncomfortable. It helped me feel better about my life and where I was going. And I believe that in some sense it probably kept me out of trouble, out of emotional trouble, psychological trouble growing up. And, you know, it's obviously a very tricky thing then to think, is it a good thing, is it a bad thing for myself, for society? You'd obviously have to consider that if you're going to promote this thing which, according to yourself, your own understanding of the world isn't true, would that be a responsible thing? And these are all questions that are very important. But for myself, it played a, I would say, largely positive role growing up. And I'm not ashamed to say it. And I know many atheists who grew up religious who had the exact opposite experience. And that seems to usually come with parents who are very religious. Whereas mine were like, go to church, Christmas and Easter, and God's nice and loves you and wants to help you, you know, that kind of stuff. So with my parents and my definition of faith, it helped. But the problem is I lost my faith, if you want to put it that way, because it just didn't make any sense. And this debate reminded me of why. Because, I mean, George Pell was a bad opponent for Richard Dawkins. But as I said, it was the same arguments round and round again. And when I first started drifting towards agnosticism, and then kind of from I don't know what happens to I don't know what happens, but probably not God. In that initial phase when I was in the agnosticism situation, I mean, I was looking, I was trying. I went to like a evangelical thing once to try that out, and I listened to people of faith and looked for that kind of inspired voice that would give me my faith back. And I didn't find it. And I'm increasingly sure I didn't find it, and I don't find it because it doesn't exist. The arguments are just, you know, the arguments are not good. Unfortunately, I don't know. I wouldn't like the Christian God. It's just, you know, as it's in the Old Testament, that would be terrible. But some kind of God, some kind of nice God that helps everyone, and for whatever reason, you know, stuff still goes wrong. Like, you could explain that. There would be ways around it. It's like, we're all part of God, and so God isn't really torturing us. It's just a natural thing, and because we're part of God and we go back into God when we die, stuff like that. You know, you can find a way out of the problem of evil and things like that, which I guess would be satisfactory. But there's just no good reason that I can see to believe in a God. And everything I've seen, and I've watched many debates, I've read a lot of stuff, and I've contemplated it a lot. And I just see a universe that is as it is. Maybe there's a hidden, like a gray eminence with the strings. Maybe there's like something after death. Maybe there's a spiritual plane. But there certainly doesn't seem to be any evidence for it that I've ever spotted. And every time these debates come up, it kind of reminds me of that. It reminds me of that journey of going and looking for things and wanting to interpret things, and also looking at stuff like reincarnation and like the evidence, and being like, oh, you know, maybe. But once I took the balance of reason, I guess, Occam's razor, something along those lines, it was always, to me, obvious enough which way the evidence weighed. Anyways, not a very profound video. I'm not really making any big statements. I just wanted to talk about a bit of my own process of thinking about faith, since I haven't really talked about my own faith or non-faith too much. And those are just some things that came to my mind while I was watching this little debate, which you might be able to find on the internet. So the Archbishop's name is George Pell, and he was debating Richard Dawkins. But on the other hand, if you want to like watch a good debate, watch something else, because it was actually quite silly. But anyways, I hope you're all doing well. I hope you all had a good Easter, you know, egg hunt or church or whatever you like to do on Easter. I did my egg hunt, and it was excellent. Much chocolate was to be had. So I'll see you guys all later.